This is the fourth video about an NEQ-6 belt modification. It's in a series of seven, so you might like to check out the others first. This stage of the project has three parts. In the first part, I'll be replacing the old brass gear in the RA worm housing with an aluminium one, along with its belt. I'll also be replacing the bearings and the worm shaft at the same time. In the second part, I'll be replacing the newly modified RA worm housing into the upper housing. And in the third part, I'll replace the upper housing, including the RA worm gear assembly, into the lower housing, which is still on the tripod. So let's get into it.
Okay, now, the first stage is to loosen these nuts here, the worm gears here. I'll just see if I can get this. Is it 2 millimeter? This is stiff, but it is moving. There we go. Just see if we can get, and then we may be able to get the whole thing off without these withdrawing completely from the. Now you can see, okay, you can see it's moving up and down on the shaft there. Okay. Now the next thing is I'm going to remove, because I'm removing and replacing both of these things, I'm going to remove both of these cups, these caps, and also the gear underneath one side of these things. The one of them has an actual locking pin in there. So this is where I use this nifty little thing from Rowan Astronomy. I have pre-loosened these, so we should come off relatively simply, he said, nearly dropping the whole thing. Now, in there, you can see the locking ring. Now, this might be difficult. Kari found it was difficult, so we'll see. I'll try, first of all, just holding it in my hand. That's locked nicely. That's not difficult at all. And there it is. Now, in theory, that should mean that I can withdraw the shaft. According to Curry, one of them's long and one of them's short. I'll just take a quick photograph of those. Yep, definitely. One of them larger than the other. Okay. That's because on that shaft, there's a flat piece, which, oh, that's it, there. Now, what I'm going to do later on is I'm going to mark that flat piece with a pen so that I can remember it for next time, because that has to go on. That's just going to come off, I think. Okay. There's one bearing to remove. There is the old wheel. And the other bearing I can bang out real quite easily, I suspect, using some sort of, I can be as butcherous as I like with that one, because it's not going anywhere. I'll just take that out. Now, I'm just going to clean this up, and then I'm going to clean that up, and I'm going to clean some other bits and pieces, and I'll get back to you. Okay, I've cleaned stuff. I've put some lithium grease over stuff. And one other thing I've done is, you may not be able to see it, I've put a small mark there where the flat section of this axle is because this is the aluminium wheel that came with the, or the cog that came with the And I think that will go on there. I'll just
what I have to do is get the loop around there, put that into, first of all, put that down that hole there, and just finagle that. That has to go forward a little bit, so it has to actually go off the shaft a bit. There we go, now it'll drop in. I think if we put this cap here, that'll hold that one in place. Now this is where we need our little pins. They go in there. And that goes on there. Let's just tighten that one up. Someone will tell me if I'm doing this wrong. Yeah, skipped it on. I thought I was going to be clever there. Just okay, that's in about the right place. I will now pause to photograph that actually. Where's my other camera? So now we'll just put this cap on. And tighten it using these pins. Right, so now there is the assembly as reassembled. There's a gap between the left and the right, the right edges of the casting there. It's on nice and strongly, and it rolls nice and nicely, and there's no axial play in that. So that's the, I think that's the idea.
Now we're going to put this back on the main house, the upper housing. So I'll bring that in. Now I'm going to be needing to see this little area here. Okay, what we'll do first of all is just move these worm gears, these worm screws out of the way, because they are going to prevent me from getting over the wheel here. So now it goes on. Okay, and then that lifts up. Just goes over there. I have to make sure that the belt, where's my tweezers? The belt should go through there. Just hold that in. And that just drops on. Here are my bolts, the ones that I saved from before, so they go in. That is that, I believe. That's the upper housing. The last part of stage four is to replace the upper housing and the RA worm housing onto the lower housing, which is here. What will happen is that I'll put the setting circle on. I've put a sticker on that so that it sits in the right there. That's the right way up. And I'll put this in there. I've greased it fairly well, but I just know that this is going to be a tight fit. It's going to be very difficult to get down there. It was a lot less tricky than I thought. Okay. Now, there we go. That looks good. Now what I'm going to do is replace the thrust bearing. Now the thrust bearing is in a packet over here. Here goes the thrust bearing. Goes into there. And it should hopefully center itself. There we go. Here is the polarscope collar. That way. The idea is to get it so that there's no movement movement that way. The tricky thing about it is to get make sure that there's that you can detect any movement that way, and because it's heavy and it stays to one side. So let's see. I can't feel any movement there. Now that goes that way when you're tightening. Doesn't feel good. Doesn't feel good to me. Possibly a little bit stiff. Let's undo it a bit. Okay, let's put the other bits and pieces on it. There you go. Right, now the collar. Clutch. And what we do is tighten that down until it stops. And then I think the idea is you put it on there. That way it will be in about the right position for you. It's unclutched. Nicely clutched. Okay, one last check. Yes, the belt is still poking through, so that's a good thing. Okay, I'll put the polarscope back and leave it at that, I think. Polarscope is in another plastic bag. Not really fussed about the polarscope. I never use it. I don't think anyone else does either. For visual users, the handbox polar alignment is far more easy than finding sigma octans in that thing. Oh my God, it's so difficult. Okay, I think we're done. I'm going to take some stills and leave it at that.